Members of the Parliamentary Committee of Rules, Discipline and Privileges met today to address the alleged misconduct by the Minister of State for Housing, Persis Namganza. This was after High Court dismissed a case which the minister was using to stop committee proceedings.
Correct information. It is our responsibility as members of parliament to defend the sacredness and the integrity of parliament. I think the public, the general public, is taking this parliament for granted. And then when they look at flask and donuts, they think we are just here for fun. We are here to eat food. We have left food on our tables, and we are here to serve this nation. We took oath to serve this country. So we will never entertain, especially this committee.
However, Namganza did not show up, but only delegated her two lawyers, led by Norman Pande, who told the committee that the minister was busy attending cabinet.
That Mondays are always cabinet days. The information I have from her is that there is cabinet today. That's why she cannot be here today.
When you appeared here the other day, you brought a letter from your client stating that she's disposed, she's preparing to travel outside. And now she's going for a cabinet meeting. There's no need for writing. It is an abuse. And you want us also to entertain that. Verbal communication cannot be filed. How do we file that communication from her?
Mr. Chairman, like I said, I am a lawyer. One, there is no lawyer in this country who would want to come and make false representation before the parliament. Two, the issue of whether there is a cabinet sitting and whether this member is part of the cabinet meeting is a matter of great national importance.
These ACT committee members accusing the minister and his lawyers of disrespecting the committee. The committee was adjourned for 30 minutes for the minister to show up, but all in vain.
It is actually an abuse. I can say you should not come back. I can rule that you should not appear here. It is already a misconduct, and we are investigating a misconduct of your client.
But I have told you what she has told me. I do not have capacity to bring her here in the next 30 minutes. If the adjournment is done, then it means I'm not going to appear again here until I am told to appear.
Later, MPs reconvened, and Namganza's lawyers still insisted that the matter before the committee is sub judice because they filed a notice of appeal in the Court of Appeal in the case where the minister challenges the ad hoc committee report, which implicated her in Nakawa Naguru land wars.
We have come here to inform the committee and perhaps the speaker that, you know what, we are still being covered by sub-rule 3D. The matter is still subject to active appellate court proceedings. As a lawyer, my understanding of the rules is that at this stage I would request that maybe the speaker, the committee, can report to her and say, you know what, yes, you cleared us, but they have come out with now this other development.
You have gone on appeal. We can still be able to determine whether the issue is sub judice or not. So do your part with your client and submit the evidence. The rest, leave it to us as the committee.
However, the vice chairperson of the committee, Charles Onen, overruled Namganza's objections on grounds that ingredients of the court case are parallel to the matter before the committee. Onen extended the last summons to the minister to appear before the committee in person tomorrow, or else the committee proceeds ex parte.
You are taking the letter writings as a leeway to continue dodging and wasting our time. So no more letter writings, in case you will still have the privilege to appear before this committee.
Chair.
Namganza was dragged to the disciplinary committee of parliament for making remarks that undermined the sanctity of parliament. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.